You know, walking is pretty underrated, but it's actually just as good as a full-blown gym session. But yeah, you have to dedicate a lot more time to it. If you're not a fan of lifting weights with heavy metal on in the background, this is definitely the choice for you. But before you grab your coat and run outside, we're going to do an experiment. This is Bob, and he's nailing his goal of walking 20,000 steps every day. He's been doing it for a while now, and he's seen big changes to his body and health. Let's watch those changes step by step. So, Bob just hates gyms. He doesn't like to sweat lifting dumbbells, and he can't stand those sore muscles the next morning. And Bob really isn't a people person, so he feels uncomfortable in a gym with a whole bunch of strangers. He wanted to get rid of all of his problems, so he took up the most effortless sport there is, walking. He did a whole evening of research online and kept coming across this number, 20,000. It's the number of steps that burns the same amount of energy as a full session at the gym. Bob picked up his phone and downloaded an app that counted his steps throughout the day. He was surprised and frustrated. Like the average Joe, Bob walked less than 4,000 steps a day. That's about 2 miles. But now he needed to walk 5 times that. So Bob just replaced his nightly movie with an hour-long walk. That should be enough. At the end of the next day, Bob came back from the fresh night air, picked up his phone again, and looked at his score. What? 10,000 steps? That's only half. But Bob was determined to make this change in his life. The next morning, he woke up 2 hours early. All this in order to leave his car in the driveway and walk to the office. Bob felt terrible for the first half hour. He was basically still asleep, and his eyes kept closing on their own. But the fresh morning air made him feel better. And when he got to work, he actually felt pretty good. But in the afternoon, his lack of sleep came back with a vengeance. Bob had to drink a lot of coffee to make it through the rest of the day. And when Bob got home, he was exhausted. He only had enough energy to make himself dinner and crawl into bed. Well, the evening walk was kind of a bust. Looks like that morning walk did him more harm than good. Next morning, Bob drew up a new plan from scratch to reach his goal of 20,000 steps. The main idea was to get those steps in, not in huge chunks on an evening walk or on the way to work, but in small chunks throughout the day. The next morning, Bob woke up as usual and felt great. This time, he drove to work, but he parked in the furthest spot possible. That was a 10-minute walk right there. Oh, and instead of the elevator, he took the steps up to his 6th-floor office. On a regular workday, he had to send texts and emails back and forth with his coworkers. But today, he didn't send out a single email. He went to see everyone in person. Some colleagues were just a couple of desks away or in the next office over. But others were on different floors or even in neighboring buildings. So if Bob wasn't up to his ears in paperwork, he carved out some time to shuttle over and talk with his coworkers in person. Lunchtime! Instead of eating in the cafeteria and then staring at his phone for 40 minutes out of boredom, Bob brought his lunch from home. He walked 15 minutes to a nearby park and ate in the fresh air. Another 15 minutes back to the office. That's another half hour. And Bob was back at his desk just in time for the end of his lunch break. Time for the weekly meeting with the boss. Okay, our hero's already in the waiting room, but the assistant says the boss is running late. Well, instead of just sitting in the chair and waiting, Bob decided to take a walk around the reception area. Great! 10 more minutes of walking in the bank. And quitting time! Bob picked up his jacket and got ready for the trip home. Once again, it's the stairs all the way down and a short hike to his parking spot. Bob got home and had a great dinner. And today, he didn't feel tired. He was actually happy to go out for his evening walk. Bob decided to walk to the lake outside of town and back. Just as he got home, he got a notification on his phone. It was his step tracker, and it was lighting up like the 4th of July. 20,000 steps. That's about 10 miles, almost as much as the length of Manhattan. For the entire week, Bob lived his new routine and used the same route every day. To achieve his goal, Bob walked for a total of 3 hours every day. He only had 24 hours to work with, and 8 of those hours were for sleeping. So those 3 hours were a big part of his day. Bob came up with another goal: use that time for something useful. So he went back to his desk and started planning. At first, he tried music on his evening walk, but that got a bit boring. Then he listened to podcasts. He got so into them that he walked right into a lamppost. And then a brilliant idea popped in his head. Share the love, share the steps. The very next day, Bob wasn't alone on his walk. He brought a 4-legged friend along. Bob became a volunteer at the local dog shelter, and now every walk was a chance for one lucky dog to sniff a bunch of trees and stuff. One night, the dog was just too cute. And now, Bob has a dog. Every day, he has the epic motivation to get out of the house and pump out those steps. He's taking care of his friend. In the morning, he wakes up to the dog licking his face, begging to go outside. In the evening, the dog meets Bob, and they go to the park together. They're both happy, and now this gym substitute feels like a chill hobby, no stress at all. So, Bob lived like this for 2 months. He walked 20,000 steps every day. And what happened to his body? You can congratulate Bob. He lost 8 pounds. And he wasn't even trying to lose weight. Just the opposite. All that walking made him hungry all the time. He was constantly eating. And he wasn't on some special diet. He was still eating the occasional burger and fries, pizza, and a whole lot of sandwiches. But that magic number of steps a day was enough to make Bob's fat start to melt right off. But it wasn't just the weight. Bob's overall health improved. Walking for at least 30 minutes a day reduces your risk of heart problems, and Bob was doing 3 hours. Bob's legs and joints stop hurting after a lifetime of sitting around all day. That's because walking helps lubricate and strengthen the muscles that support your joints. And it increases oxygen levels in the body. It's more invigorating than a cup of coffee. And those awesome happiness hormones that get released made him a hit at the office. So, say you want to go all Bob and start walking 20,000 steps a day. Remember a couple of important details. It's better to do a whole bunch of 15-minute walks than 1 or 2 marathon sessions. This will keep your legs from getting tired or injured and allow you to manage your time better. If you're walking in the evening, wear something reflective on your t-shirt or pants. If it's sunny out, wear a cap and use sunscreen. 3 hours of sun is a lot. Your shoes should be comfortable and have good ankle support. Definitely don't wear your work shoes. And so you don't get bored during your walk, share that time with your thoughts, music, friends, family. Or you can always get yourself a furry friend. All that walking is going to be useful for both of you.